Miss Allen, you say that after a brief affair with Mr. Childs, you discovered you were pregnant with your daughter, Ms. Baylor. You say Mr. Childs acknowledged paternity until his wife convinced him otherwise. You intend to prove that Mr. Childs is, in fact, your daughter's father. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Mr. Childs, you admit to the affair with Ms. Allen, but say she was involved with several other people around the time of conception. You and your wife contend that you are not Ms. Baylor's father. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ms. Allen, why is Mr. Childs denying your daughter?
His petty wife. She's been doing that for years. She wasn't there when we were sleeping together or nothing. So I don't think she have anything to do with it.
So you're basically blaming his wife?
Yes.
She should blame herself, Your Honor.
What?
Why did it take you 20 years to figure out that you should get a DNA test?
Because I didn't need to go through the drama with you.
Let's talk one at a time, because I do want to understand this. How did you all even get together?
She was friends with cousins of mine, and we got together like that. We ended up messing around or whatever. Nothing serious.
So you all get together, yeah. You have mutual friends, you start having sex.
Well,
obviously unprotected.
It started like this. We had a friend that got killed. And me and him, you know, I would call and check on him and things like that. Then one day, I just came through after a football game, and he wanted to ride with me. And so we went on and had drinks or whatever. And then that's when we had sex.
Is this the night you believe you conceived after the football game and the drinks?
Yes.
Was this the only time you were intimate with Mr. Child?
We just did it like maybe couple times after that.
Okay, so this didn't extend for a long time. This is just a few encounters.
No. Yeah.
Then you say you got pregnant, mm-hmm. And once you got pregnant, did you tell Mr. Childs, I'm pregnant and I think it could be yours?
Actually, it was rumors, so he came
you
to me.
You spread the rumor. People are coming
okay,
to me. Okay,
if I had family and I'm pregnant or whatever, but...
Why aren't you telling the truth? You didn't know who the father was.
Well, you knew that from day one.
You were telling that...
You knew that from day one.
That's not what you were saying, though.
Hold on, I'm going to give both of you a chance to respond to the other, but I want to understand. Ms. Allen, what is your contention?
I told him, I said, she may be your child.
You told him directly?
Yes. I told him, I said, it's a possibility that she may not be.
So you said it is a possibility that she may not be yours.
Exactly.
So you acknowledge this doubt?
Yeah.
Mr. Child.
Yes, ma'am.
How did the story go in your assessment?
Your Honor, listen, wasn't no, hey, listen, I'm trying to get at you or anything like that. No, never that. It's just a moment that happened. So I even asked her, you know, once I found out, I heard she was pregnant. Hey, are you pregnant? You supposed to be pregnant by me? Oh, I don't know. I don't know if it's yours or not. So I'm like, okay, I'll tell you what. If you're pregnant and it's mine, let's get a DNA test. We can go ahead and get this out of the way. Have no problem with taking care of her because she would have been my first. I don't see her again for months. Probably longer than that, Your Honor.
So, Ms. Allen, when Ms. Baylor was born, you didn't invite him to the birth?
No.
Did you invite any other man?
No.
Did you inform the other possibility or the other possibilities that they may be the father as well? You did?
Yes.
Okay. If you say he might be the father, why are you in court today saying that he is the father?
Because I was messing with him first.
How do you know
What you mean, how do I know that? I had to go through the drama with Ms. Johnson. Up and down the road, she followed me.
How can she remember me chasing her up and down the street, but she can't remember who fathered her child? Why am I living in her head rent-free, but she can't remember who fathered her child? Furthermore, Your Honor, he's always been there for my children. So this little song and dance she's doing, I'm telling the truth.
Okay,
I think it's important to know, too. Whatever. When we met her daughter, the daughter told us that she had tested someone else. Why didn't you test him first?
So, Ms. Allen, there has been testimony which indicates that you also tested another man.
Yes, she did.
Is that true?
Okay, that is true.
Okay.
That is true.
Tell the court about that.
That is true, but that was somebody that I wasn't even messing with him. This was something that
Why would you test someone you aren't messing with?
Because he came out and asked me, and he said, you know, I was messing with your mom around the time. I wanted to get a DNA test with you.
Okay, someone reached out to you,
yes.
Ms. Baylor, and said, I think I may be your father, and I want to have a test.
Yeah, I want to have a test.
But Ms. Allen, you say this person was never a consideration.
No, I told him that, but he was insisting on it. I was like, that is not, I wasn't even messing with you back then.
So the bottom line is, Ms.
She don't know. That's the bottom line.
Allen, you have not had a DNA test with any of the other true potential fathers.
Right.
Okay, so Shinesha, Ms. Baylor, were you always told Mr. Childs was your biological father?
To be honest, Your Honor, I was about 14 when I first found out my sister's dad wasn't my dad. Just hearing rumors, just going over my grandmother's house in Bowling Green. And that's where basically he is from. And everybody would come to me like, you're my cousin, TJ's your dad. I'm like, I don't know who TJ is. Who is TJ? And I went about it myself. I found him on Facebook, hit him up, and I said, look, I don't know what's going on, but I do actually want to know.
And did I ever once deny you?
Nah, you never did.
Never once. Never once. A child looking for a father, Your Honor, and I stand a chance of being it, I'm going to be there. Yeah. I'm going to be there. You can ask it. We conversated. We talked everything.
So, Ms. Baylor, first you believed until you were 14 years old that your sibling's father was your biological father.
Her stepfather. Yes.
Then people were murmuring, and you were told by whom that that was not your biological father.
Well, basically, my stepdad was telling me stories, and he said when he met my mom, then she was already pregnant with me.
Okay.
You know,
so your stepfather told you the truth.
Yes. So I don't know if he meant to, but when he told me, I was just like, I just started asking questions. I just wanted to know.
Right.
And I wanted to get to the bottom of it.
Yes.
She knew. I told her, sit down and told her the whole story.
Yeah, she told me after. She didn't like tell me before, but she told me after the fact when my stepdad did say that.
Okay.
No, she sat down and talked to me when I brought it to her attention. Like, and then, I don't know what's going on. I'm confused.
I know,
I'm
honey.
I'm confused, too.
I know, and that's why I'm trying to understand this, because at the end of the day, you have a right to understand
exactly
what happened.
Your Honor, in 2006, I got in touch with Ms. Baylor, and I told her that I wanted to meet Shy.
11 years ago, you would have been 9, Ms. Baylor.
Yes, ma'am.
So you made an attempt to meet Ms.
Yes,
Baylor
ma'am.
At 9 years old.
Yes, ma'am.
But you weren't informed of any of this till you were 14.
No, ma'am. I met her. I sat down and talked to her at Ms. Allen's house.
I'd never denied that he
then
never tried.
Then why wouldn't you tell her? Why wouldn't you tell her?
I felt like I never saw this man in my life. Like, when people was telling me when I was 14, I'm like, I don't know. Nobody named TJ. I don't remember him or none of this.
I mean, you were only 9. You don't remember him at all.
I don't remember nothing.
And let me ask you this, Mr. Childs. It seems as if you were making earnest attempts to find out. Is it that you still had a question in your mind, so you were just trying to see it through?
I just wanted to see it through, Your Honor. I'm saying like this. If it was such a struggle for her to raise her by herself, and you know where I am, if I'm such a bad person, go get child support. When we went to child support, I would have got a DNA test. And this would have been taken care of years ago. I've been going on years, Your Honor, with people saying, oh, you know Shy's your daughter. Oh, you know Shy's your daughter. I don't want people looking at me like, oh, you're a deadbeat dad. No, I do what I have to do to take care of my family.
So, wait, I want to ask Miss Allen, if this was the man you truly believed was your child's father, why didn't you ever pursue child support?
I basically was working and just taking care of her on my own.
Or was it that you just really knew that you didn't know for sure if it was him?
Well, it didn't even matter, because I just was kind of going through the drama with her.
It didn't matter to you. You can't say that.
So I went on with my life. I took care of her by myself.
So, Ms. Allen, you never in the court system pursued a DNA test? Nothing?
No.
All right?
Your Honor, she just made me feel like she wanted me to be the father by name. So if someone asked her who Shy's father was, she could say me. You know, Your Honor, please. I'm not being funny or anything, but okay, I was a good catch. I'm not gonna lie, I was a good catch. So I can understand, you know, where she was coming from then. I would have made sure she was fine. I would have made sure the child was fine. All that would have been good. What I'm saying is there was no way to keep up with her. You know, when she had the baby, Your Honor, she brought the baby to my mom's house one time. And I told her right then and there, look, Niecy, we can get this straight now so we don't have any problems in the future. She disappeared.
And you say he didn't say that, Miss Allen?
Mr. Childs was doing other things. And
I'm not saying I wasn't. Yeah,
and I wasn't even the only one he was messing with. He was messing with my cousins and all that stuff. So That's why I just went on about my business.
What does that have to do with the child at hand, Your Honor?
Yeah, it doesn't, but
exactly.
At the same time.
That's what I'm saying. I've been going through, Your Honor. She's not concerned about her. She's concerned about her.
Mr. Child, I'm concerned about her too.
You wore my name through the mud for years, Niecy.
How did I bring your name through the mud?
I've been telling people, see, my baby won't take a DNA test. How is that not running my name through the mud?
Okay.
People looking at me like I don't take care of a child. You're crazy.
Okay. Okay.
It's funny to you. It ain't funny to me.
I'm not. Hey, do what you got to do.
Of course.
All I'm saying is we're here for her.
Listen.
Your Honor, can I say something?
Mr. Child, you have other children?
Yes, ma'am. Well taken care of. She knows I would have took great care of this girl. Great care.
So, Mr. Childs and Miss Johnson, do you have any additional doubt?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
You do?
Ma'am.
Okay.
I have some evidence right here, Your Honor.
Let me see the evidence, Jerome. Yes. Will you describe what this evidence is, sir?
My first evidence is with my children. All my children have 6 fingers, Your Honor. Both of my kids are very tall and look just like me. All my kids look just like me. You know, I'm not saying that, you know, that doesn't mean she's not my child. It's just that I feel I have strong genes. So, you know.
So you're saying all of your children,
yes,
all
ma'am.
Of your other children have been born with a 6th finger.
Yes, ma'am. Just like myself.
And that's a physical characteristic you share with them.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. And when we were pregnant with the 7-year-old, we had an ultrasound done. And at that point, as soon as he hit my stomach, she lift her hand up, and there it was dingling.
Another digit
is what they called it. So if we asked them about that, and they said it would be hereditary. Who got it?
Mr. Childs, are there other members of your family with this 6th finger?
No, ma'am.
Ms. Johnson, on your side?
I don't have it, but I found out later on my dad had 6 fingers. But none of us, like my brother or sister, none.
And so the gene could have come from your side.
It could have. But it was just interesting. None of
us. So interesting.
Yep. They don't.
So, Ms. Allen, are you still convinced that Mr. Childs is her biological father?
Yes.
You do believe that?
I really do.
After today's results, what are you hoping?
I mean, if he is, you know, the father, I want them to have a relationship. And I mean, I'm out of it because she's 20. So at the same time, if he's not, then we move on. That's fine with me.
I just have to say, you know, on your behalf, and I don't mean to speak for you, Ms. Baylor, but this is something she has not moved on. Mm-hmm. She deserves an answer. Yep. And I don't know, Shanisha, it's been a lot of talk about the past and what people do and what they did, but I want you to know you matter. Mm-hmm. You are all that matters mm-hmm. in this moment. What are your hopes?
Basically, I'm just hoping that I can just close this chapter that I do have open in my life. You know, if it's not closing, I'ma keep trying to close the chapter. There's nothing that I can be mad about because my mom been taking care of me since, you know?
Exactly. And I want, and I hope, as the adults here in this situation, you all can understand that I think it is so amazing that you can stand in this courtroom today and say, you know, I'm not mad about it. But I do want you to understand that it is perfectly okay for you to be hurt about it. And that's okay to admit. This is a lot to have to process. And every girl, every boy, you need your dad. And even though you've had a wonderful experience being raised by your mother, it sounds like you had a nice stepfather as well. At 14 years old, to get that kind of news, and then from that point on, for 6 more years beyond that, to have questions and confusion, you can be strong and still acknowledge that you're hurt. Family, are we ready for the results?
Yes, Doug.
Let's do it. Jerome? These results were prepared by DNA Diagnostics, and they read as follows. In the case of Baylor versus Childs, when it comes to 20-year-old Shanisha Baylor, it has been determined by this court. Mr. Childs, you are not the father. I'm very sorry, Miss Baylor.
It's okay, Your Honor. You know, at the same time,
It's okay, honey. It's okay.
I would like to apologize to the both of you for that. No. And we can move on.
That's fine.
I really wanted to give you the closure you need and deserve, Ms. Baylor. And I'm sorry this was not the answer. But I just want you to understand this is just one step. This now takes this particular question out of the picture. And now we move forward, right? I hope you will continue to answer her questions, no matter how difficult, Ms. Allen. Mm-hmm. And do whatever is necessary to help her identify and find her biological father, all right? Don't ever feel like this is your fault. Don't ever feel like you are to blame. And I want you to know how much you are worth it. You are a strong girl. But it's okay in life to say, Mom, this really hurts me. I need you to help me, okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. I have counseling and resources for you all.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Wish you the very best of luck. Court is adjourned.